In this video, I'll show the difference between reveal all and hide all layer masks and why it's important. Bear with me, because first I'll show what is obvious, but then some problems you might run into. First, if there isn't a selection and we add a layer mask, by default, the mask is reveal all, which is all white. Draw black on it and the area is hidden. Change the canvas size, and more white is added to the mask, the default for reveal all masks. Now back up and do the opposite. Add a layer mask. This time, invert it. Now it becomes a hide all mask. Draw white on it, and the area is revealed. Change the canvas size, and more black is added to the mask, the default for hide all masks. Okay, none of this is any big surprise. Trust me, we're getting there. I'll start over. First, more that is obvious. Choose the layer for the model and use Select Subject. Add a layer mask. Because there's a selection, it's used to make the mask. Again, nothing new here, but there's a crucial difference that's not obvious. Because it's made from a selection, the mask is hide all instead of reveal. Increase the canvas, and the mask grows with it. All good. Now here's where things go off track. I'll step back to the original canvas size. I have a solid color layer for a background I want to overlay. I'll Command-click the model's mask to get a selection of it. Now turn on the solid color layer. We want the model to show through, so it makes sense to invert the selection and mask the color layer, right? That seems to work, but there's a problem. Make the canvas size larger. The mask has black bars on the sides because we made a hide all mask, which defaults to black, not white. We want a reveal all mask instead. Okay, I'll back up and do it right. Instead of inverting the selection, leave it a selection of the model. Hold the Option key. On Windows, the Alt key. Now click the Layer Mask button. Holding Option tells Photoshop to make a Reveal All Mask instead. Increase the canvas size. Now it works right. But what if you have a pile of images already masked the wrong way? Let's make an action to fix it. Follow along and make your own action. But first, select the problem mask. Now, in the Actions panel, click the Flyout menu. Select New Action. I'll name it Fix Mask. Command-click the mask to get a selection of it. Invert the mask. Delete the mask. Hold down Option and click the Add Layer Mask button to make the mask again. Press the Actions panel Stop button to finish recording. Let's try it. I'll quickly make the mask again the wrong way and show that it adds the black bars we don't want. Select the problem mask and run the action. And now you can see it works right. It's also good to know the action works even when the layer is already masked correctly. Either way, the action makes it right. One last thing to mention, not related to this problem, but it is related to layer masks. When adding an adjustment layer, it gets a mask by default. Maybe you don't mind, but I find this annoying. Go to the Window menu. Adjustments. In the Adjustments panel, click the Flyout menu. Here's where you can turn that behavior on or off. Just so you know. Like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe so you're notified of future videos. Also, leave a comment. I always like to hear from you. All feedback is welcome. There are plenty of other tutorials. Click the video or playlist on screen for more. Thank you for watching.